Alex Morgan on his speed bike with you riding backpack.
The safest you've ever found.
Kick up a dust trail as you're navigating and driving behind as he seems to be able to lead and navigate you guys deep into the desert. This is about 60 or 70 miles into the wasteland, the abyss, and it seems that you guys are approaching a canyon. The flat desert, there seems to be rock formations, tall cliffs, small little boulders, everything. It's very, almost like Joshua Tree right now, as there's just a bunch of rock formations scattered. As...
I am matching where we all onto my map.
Intelligence check.
Sick, I passed. 16.
How are you the only one that survived?
We just rode in silence for like 6 hours, and this is the first thing that you say to me. Were you thinking about this a lot, rehearsing it, practicing it?
Pretty much, yeah.
I'm the one that made it because I'm the only one that has any navigation skills in that group.
Damn, so you just left everybody else? You didn't navigate them out of the desert?
Would you do the same?
I mean, I wouldn't say I would not do the same, but time will tell.
Let's get to work.
How many people did you eat, Alex?
Man, the car pulls up. Car pulls up behind, and it seems that you are in a relatively good area to start setting up camp. As Alfie's, I'm on it! As he starts running around the car and emptying out the supplies and like, starts setting up the tent. This, you know, this luxurious, almost dozen person sized tent, you know.
It's just for me, by the way.
As he's working on that in the vicinity of where this trench would be. You have a general sense on where to dig, but you're not completely confident.
Start digging.
Make an archaeology check.
Hold on. First off.
Well, it would most likely be a descending entrance.
You stand and you feel your father's presence. I'm here.
Father.
She must be high.
You feel confident. This is a good place to start digging.
We dig here.
Who grabs a shovel? Every person that grabs a shovel ups production time.
I grab a shovel.
I do not grab a shovel.
A shovel?
I don't even know how to say shovel.
The sooner we're out of here, the better.
Everyone, y'all, you guys might want to watch out for booby traps.
Great. Well, I will sit over here.
Quite possibly
in the shade.
A sand trap.
You guys can dig a little bit.
Alex grabs a shovel.
Can I jump?
As the dig begins, everyone please, if you're an archaeologist, make your archaeology check. If you're not, make your strength check to...
Oh, God.
Do I have to
shovel,
work?
It's gonna whack and
that's your call,
the
bud. You're funding this. Right now, Alfie's finished the tent.
I am not going...
Alfie, can you dig for me?
Yes!
Alfie, can you dig for me?
No!
No, he works for me.
If you and Alfie dig, we'll be just going that much faster.
All right, fine, I'll do the strength check.
I'm so you. Just looking for shovel.
Oh no, I didn't pass. I have to.
Raise your hand if you passed.
Oh God, I'm so sorry.
Alfie got a 20.
Oh, I hit a rock and break my wrist.
Alfie passed for you. He did do your, he did do the digging for you.
Thank you, Alfie.
Your shovels spend the next several days carving out the earth.
Days.
Yes, that's how long these things take. Days. Days. You signed up for this.
This part of the dig is relatively easy as this emplacement, this trench, is only 10 years lost to time as the ground is not yet fully hard and that buries it. As your shovels eventually hit wood. The tip of this World War I trench, the trench that your father built, the trench where this artifact was discovered. You then continue to excavate, and it seems like there are parts of it that are lost, but overall, this World War I trench has been unveiled. It goes about 12 feet deep into the earth here.
Oh.
As there are ladders, maybe some sandbags. Does anybody explore the trenches further?
No, thank you.
I can jump
in them.
I go.
Everyone make a spot hidden for this spot here. As you've discovered the trench,
Yay. But
you have not discovered maybe where he found this artifact.
I pass.
Pass.
No.
We'll start with you, Eliza, here. As caked in layers of sand and dust, a World War I trench gun.
Shit, I want that.
That they would use to clear trenches that they would have here. And...
Okay. Look at that.
That's cool. Wow.
Philomena.
Yes.
Your shovel. Stone.
You can
wood.
It's been in a trench for 10 years.
Sand. crunch, it seems to hit a bone-like material.
Oh no.
Bedded kind of into the wall.
I crouch down died in London, and I call over Gwen, because she'll have the tools for some. I'll go, Gwen, I think I've hit bone. Let me see.
Archaeology check.
Pass, 32.
Oh, I failed completely.
You dust, you uncover, you use your all your tools.
What the hell are you doing?
This is like an Animal Crossing.
Oh my god, she's so good at what she does.
As you unveil a
what'd you get?
Fossil, a skull.
Oh my god, say Helanthropus chadensis.
My god.
I know my skulls.
Can I do a history check on... No, anthropology! Can I do an anthropology check?
Yes, you can!
Oh, that's a pass. Mm-hmm.
These bones you can immediately date way further than World War I. Mm-hmm. This is not even close in the thousands of years.
Oh my god.
We found it. It's here.
That we did.
Yes.
We're in the right spot.
In this environment, as you spend these days, you notice that there's a particular time of day where the sun dips over the ridge line and shade fills it. Very nice and cooling. But you do notice that on this ridge line, there seems to be a perfectly carved circle in the shape of the sun that lets it peer through. As that sun dips upon the ridge line, there is one part of this ridge that allows that sun to beam through that illuminates. But where that spot hits currently is outside of the trench. It seems like it's going further below.
We might want to expend the dig.
Keep digging.
We have to dig now in that spot.
Yes.
Just keep digging.
Make an archaeologist check.
Sweet Jesus.
Those who have it.
Two.
Critical?
Nice.
What did I find? What did I discover?
Feverishly dig as the lust of discovery fills you as you guys dig past the trench line. They only would dig about 12 feet for what they needed, but you guys progress to 15 feet, to 20 feet, as the dig begins to grow and grow and grow over the days. It's very tiring. Your hands are so blistered, you're exhausted. The heat is giving you fatigue and heat stroke and everything. As your shovels hit a pitch black rock, a obsidian type material as it clings and chips as... Okay.
Make a jump.
I'll do a history check.
I just want to jump over.
I passed.
Both of you kind of excavate the perimeter of this tip as you reveal that it will be.
Excavate the perimeter of the tip.
That was not a good
idea. I quit. It's very exciting. History is very.
Well then,
it's exciting!
Oh my god!
As you find the tip of an erect obelisk.
No! Why do you have to say like that?
You started it. I will finish what you started.
What we started?
What I started.
I guess we funnel the tip.
I understand why we're here now.
I finally found it.
It all makes sense.
As
Am I able to read what's on it?
Currently, it is pitch black.
No, I cannot.
May I jump on it?
This obsidian obelisk is extremely large here as this, you guys are having it's almost like a few stories high. I would say is, this is definitely a shrine or something of much importance here.
Isn't this amazing?
Calm down. Quite spectacular.
I know, it's just like I've read, it's maybe shorter than I expected, but we need some light. I would love some light to be able to.
I would say it's about average size.
Size does matter.
Is it at night right now?
Sunset approaches.
Can I feel it and try and spot it just by the tactile sensation?
You can.
36 out of 80.
Which side of the obelisk are you searching?
The side that the sun would hit once it came over the ridge.
Okay. Then you can see that there is an outline for something to potentially unlock a compartment.
Does it seem amulet-shaped?
Currently, nope.
Does it seem skull-shaped?
Currently, nope.
Can I see your gun real fast? Just real quick. I ain't gonna shoot you. I just need it real fast. I'm gonna take out my hairpin. I'm gonna take out the pin from the pistol. And I'm going to see if...
Make...
Jerry Rig.
A lock picking...
You didn't want to ask any of the other check. People
to think about the
hairpin.
It's cooler.
It's really hot.
That's a critical success. That's great.
Yay!
Then I'm going to give you a warning here. As you are picking the lock, when you click and unlock the compartment, you hear the swirling compressed gas as you have 0.1 seconds to react before this compartment sprays out in acidic salt gas. Ooh. Make a dodge roll.
Let me acidic salt check. Let me acidic salt.
Success. That's a four. That's critical. Ooh.
Because of your success and your warning, as you click, you immediately fly back as just spewing in this entire area this gas, this powder, as it just sprays everywhere. As it goes, you roll out of the way. Hargraves, Philomena, you just back up as it just sprays a large circumference of this area, at least 15 feet in a cone. As this would have fried everybody alive.
Thanks.
That was close. All
right, can I you saw that happen from above with Alfie.
Oh, I'm just like, marvelous, an acidic salt gas used to deter intruders.
You guys
that
okay?
That looked very violent. Is everyone all right?
Yeah, are you okay?
You should come down. This is absolutely fascinating.
I think I'm going to stand here.
Oh, that's right. 4,000
years. Would you like another drink, sir?
That's fascinating.
It's
you.
Thank you,
Alfie.
That is
wild.
4,000.
We're running dangerously low on supplies.
I'm seeing everything I've read about in action.
Are we going to die? How close are we to... do we have water?
Probably only have a little bit longer here.
All right.
What's that? Was a little
before we have to go back to town and get more supplies.
Great. Are you able to do that?
How many days?
Do you want me to go run an errand back to the city and get more?
Can you take Alex's bike and do that?
Oh, good.
I don't know how to ride a motorcycle.
You know how to drive?
You taught me.
That's right. I taught you a lot of things. Yeah, go take the car and get us some supplies and come back here.
Yes, sir. As he goes.
No, we don't have a fucking car!
Car and drives away! Give me Alfie.
Worrisome.
He goes to the city.
Now we have to find horses at some point. Oh no, we have to find horses.
That's why we did it just with
the horses. I want the horses.
Okay. The gas seems to clear. It seems that the air in this area is tolerable and you can investigate further.
Well, I opened it. So,
continue.
Someone should.
No, I'm gonna tap out for this
one. It's only
one.
Fair, it's only fair.
All right.
I say...
Go ahead, doctor. Did you come down with us? Are you still on top?
I say... someone that has more strength, maybe more bravery, look at the next thing, perhaps. It's a really heavy door.
It takes all your strength to open this freaking obelisk's compartment as revealing there seems to be... four circular slots. Amulet-shaped slots.
Four.
Does anybody want to tell me what I'm looking at here?
It's four slots. Amulet-shaped slots.
Okay.
And we have one of them, so we just have to find the three others.
So that is a problem.
Look, keep digging.
Are you serious?
Current floor reaches rock bottom here.
Just out of curiosity, when you were with Renald.
Why does everyone keep interviewing me?
Oh no, I was just wondering. For any prior...
Not really that interesting.
Yeah,
are you flirting?
Anyways, with the whole thing, I'm just wondering. With Bel Air, were you looking for anything? What were you looking for?
MOS is not to ask too many questions. My job was to lead them to where they wanted to dig in. They seem to have false information on what they were looking for.
But you didn't hear what they were initially looking for.
Nope. My job is to guide.
And shoot. And if we said anything about multiple amulets, it doesn't...
Why are you talking about amulets?
Bellar's looking for everything to sell, but I can assure you that he didn't find anything. In his last expedition and the one that our friend also failed in, it seems like these guys just pick anywhere they want and they just, oh, there's got to be something below it. And a lot of people die and a lot of money's wasted.
I'm going to my mind palace. I'm going to my mind palace.
Can I come down and...
Can you use your sense that you had earlier.
What sense? Your daddy sense.
No, not a daddy sense. You just had a good sense.
My vibes.
Yeah, your vibes.
I'm a vibe detector.
Yeah, pretty much. Can you use that same vibe to detect any other
it's
these?
It's called being a good archaeologist.
Just before sunset.
Can I follow my gut again to find where these...
When's Alfie coming back?
Can I take the amulet I have and use it as a magnet of sorts to find the others?
You spent a good hour going, wah, 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 wah. Like almost like a metal detector guy at the beach. It's like, bloop, beep, bloop, bloop, bloop.
She's crazy.
You find nothing.
I find nothing?
You find nothing.
What is she doing?
But you can confirm that there's no magnetic field.
Does the amulet even
the
fit in one of the slots?
Perfectly.
Yep. It fits perfectly.
Okay,
but I don't
what's on the
what does it do when it goes in? Anything?
Do you want to find out?
No.
Do you want to find out?
No.
If so, make a sleight of hand to steal it from
bitch,
Gwen.
Sixteen.
Can I do wait, can I do a spot object to see if I notice?
I take it.
Spot hidden, you need to beat a 16.
I gotta beat a 16? Well, let's see. I do not beat a 16.
I love that
weird.
Yoink.
Yes. Yes. Well, this guy. So we have to see if it works.
Do you wanna do it nonchalantly or do you just walk up and place it?
Yeah, I know who should do it. I think Alex should do it.
Why?
I'm gonna charm you into doing it for us.
If it gets us out of this desert, sure, charm me.
36. You're doing it.
God. Give me that. Like, as you're also noticing that it was stolen from you, as now everyone is playing.
My amulet!
I do. Click! it seems like it could turn. You want me to turn?
Don't turn it.
Click! Whatever these markings are, maybe it'll align with something later on, but as it clicks, it has a perfect. You do hear one of these four intense mechanisms. As whatever this is unlocked is not fully complete.
Thank God. So it's
so we need the other three, for sure.
Of course we need the other three!
The that sun begins to set as well as you also.
Why do you think I was looking for the other
three? A very ominous breeze blows through this dig site here as it whips up everything.
That felt like an ominous breeze!
Did Alfie
I
get
need everybody to make a dexterity check here. As the wind seems to pick up and pick up and pick up in intensity.
I'm fine.
21.
Critical success.
Passed. 84.
Whoever failed, you get knocked around with this wind. It seems to rush with such intensity. You have to hold on. As you fly into a nearby rock, hitting your head, losing your one life unconscious. As you have suffered head trauma.
You dead?
You lose one life as well from 5 to 4. As you bash against the wall as well. As the storm kicks up.
I start crying.
And then it stops.
Slap him. I'm gonna go over and start. I go over. Does anyone else here have first aid or is it just me?
Where's Alfie with the groceries?
I need you to shut up for a second. Two people are dying.
I don't think he's dying.
Make your first aid checks.
Okay, I'm gonna do you first because you're unconscious and I'm a little afraid. 60 meets it, beats it. 60. Exactly. So you're stable now. I'm also gonna do. I do head trauma, you should slap someone. I lift up your head and I like do a cool compress. I'm like.
I need another cigarette.
You got it.
I have never been more hurt.
And then I'm going to go to you, Joseph.
I don't know about y'all, but I don't necessarily feel like it's the best choice if we stay in here for the night.
I think we need to find the other amulets.
Well, if I was able to look at it before...
Yeah.
I would... Before anything, really.
I'm a little...
I could help.
What happens if we take it out?
My question is, why would you think the other three are here if the other one was all the way in London?
It wasn't in London! My father found it here! That's why I brought you here!
Ah, makes sense.
Oh my God.
Sunset. Everything in this area becomes shaded for quite a moment until the sun beams through that sun carving in the ridgeline, which emulates that beam, as deep below the earth, you are seeing this sun ray go and shine and illuminate. It hits the exact tip of this obelisk as it starts to warm the base of this obelisk as illuminating the shine of golden hieroglyphics. Language check.
74, I pass.
As the sun is continuing to dip, the hieroglyphics are disappearing as they appear, so I'd say three rows are visible, and as the two are spawning, as one's spawning, one's stable, and one's disappearing all at once as it goes down, 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 down.
I also passed.
On language? I speak.
What are they teaching you in Georgia?
Egyptians! Almost like when you're skimming a book, skimming, reading. You can read locating the tomb of the accursed. There is a great warning. Leave, this is a cursed land, etc., etc. This, flee while you can, do not progress, like, get out of here. There is mentions of a chamber of the sun and a chamber of the cursed. Eventually, the sun completely vanishes in the shade. Is anyone up top anymore?
Well, I came down to give the thing to Alex, but I scurry back up. Because I'm like,
oh my gosh.
I jump.
As you jump. Okay, roll, make a jump check.
Like Mario.
I didn't pass.
So my question is, how did you learn?
I fall.
As you reach the top.
Yes.
You're gonna fall and die.
On the horizon, you know where the sun went. A tsunami of sand rising and rising
in
the distance as an unnatural phenomenon.
That does not seem good.
A sandstorm of catastrophic scale.
Jump
blocks out the light as you guys are almost in total darkness, almost like an eclipse-level darkness as it is getting closer and closer.
Is the tent still there?
Yes, but it's like...
Everyone now can see this. Even 50 feet down in the earth, you can kind of see now that it's getting closer.
We hunker
it's
down.
Like a giant cloud.
We hunker down.
Where?
Below.
Listen, I take a bit of my water, I pour it onto my scarf, and I wrap it around my mouth and nose to protect myself from the sandstorm. And
as a sandstorm hits the dig site, as this clustering sand flows past you, tries to, it blocks your eyes, it blinds you. You are holding down as you notice that there is a almost like a burning sensation with this sand, that it's not natural. Everybody here make a constitution saving throw.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, I pass.
You have a chance here if you want to hide in the compartment of the obelisk there.
All right, here we go.
What is this roll?
Oh, nice, 19 out of...
You rush into this compartment, gotta use it to block as everyone who failed your check lose one life. The storm
my
passes
constitution.
As the moon rises forth.
I'm gonna die.
Sandstorm goes through. Your dig site was backed up just a little bit because there's these piles of sand now rest everywhere.
Yeah. I do look to everyone. Does anyone need medical assistance?
Can I be healed?
I'm gonna go to her first. I'm going to her first.
I have a boo-boo too.
Okay, a 20.
First,
you're back
you.
Up. I'll heal Alex.
Try.
And then I'll do you very begrudgingly.
I'll do you.
Oh no, I failed. Wait, it's
looks
a critical
like
fail. 97.
Can you help, Alex? Can you heal me?
Yeah. I'll try.
I critical fail. Does that do anything?
It doesn't hurt him further. That would kill him. You kill him.
Try.
Yeah.
Oh,
I
actually
pass.
Oh my god, he healed me.
You notice that he starts bringing out some weird penance. It's like,
and I was like, why do I feel better all of a sudden?
Wait. Here, I have crystals.
That's a disclaimer. Don't you think? I don't believe in curses, but it was...
Get the guns, we're going in.
I mean, oh. Are we not, really?
So what happens with the other three spaces, though? What happens?
We find the amulets and put them in.
That's what I'm saying, we need to find the
amulets. So they're inside.
They're inside, yes.
And there's three amulets that are missing?
There are three passages and three amulets.
So that means we have to split up.
Not necessarily. It'll just take a lot longer.
I'm going with the...
It's a pretty
Jonathan
human.
Over here.
All right.
Well, I'm with Alex.
And I'll go with the lovely Eliza.
Got the brains in this group.
So it's us
I'm
and
with
Alex.
Alex.
Us and Alex, you two and you two.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Let's say that we all meet back here in like...
20 minutes.
20 minutes.
Team A, is this Chamber of Sun or Chamber of Cursed?
We'll take the Chamber of Sun. Sun.
Okay. Any of you guys, I need... Sun chamber to make an archaeologist roll.
I think it's a trick question. I think the cursed chamber is actually the nicer one.
20, so I pass.
I had a critical pass with three.
Did Alfie come back?
That's why.
No!
Oh!
Alfie's gone!
For the chamber of the sun, you have to go up and then back into the canyon, and then as for you guys, through the canyon as well. As you guys reach the top level floor, you realize that your tent is gone. Your tent is gone from the sandstorm. It is blown away, as well as all the supplies.
But we didn't have much of it.
And Alex runs to his bike as it is, like, oozing out sand as it is inoperable currently.
Right. So we're stranded here.
No.
He tries to fix it. Clank, clank. Both of you find your respective entrances. We'll start with the cursed tomb. Gwen.
Yes.
You lead this archaeology thing based off of that. You find what seems to be the cursed path that was mentioned from the hieroglyphics that our wonderful librarian explained to you. A rock natural pit that seems to open up that goes down.
Can I peer over the pit and say, echo?
echo. It seems to go about, I would say 30 feet down and bounces back to you. It seems that it's a very narrow chamber. It almost is like, it is the size of this room and it goes down.
Jump and don't make it.
Does anyone, you have a torch, by the way, Gwen. That is part of your kit.
I do have a torch.
It is part of a infrastructure, a chamber, as you see murals the size of building stories here, as there is a whole ass, in each wall, a great mural of different, you can't really read it because there's hieroglyphics that are too small, but there seems to be almost like a tomb of the ancients here, or history lesson, or a clue, or something down there that these murals are trying to tell you. At the very bottom, there seems to be another chamber door.
Can we climb down?
You can! Sorry, I got very excited.
You were waiting.
Have climb.
Climb check! You do have climb. I was like, wow.
Climb.
Look at you being resourceful.
I have jump.
Yeah, you want to jump.
Pause, 22.
Like
of course.
I can climb now. You're really talented.
You use your hand pick and you use your everything at your disposal. You scale down these rocks, just natural rock climbing, as you do make it to the base here.
What's happening? What do you see? What's there?
Lots of stuff. Come down.
Alex, now that she's gone, we should talk about us.
Can I do history?
I would.
Or an archaeology?
This would be language.
Fuck.
You have to read the hieroglyphics.
Sorry.
You're very bad at that.
You could come and get me.
I will say I'll let you make a history check for a little bit of clues, but I can only pepper it.
I passed it.
Okay, this is the clues that I can give you. These murals have paintings of what seems to be rituals. There seems to be hands reaching from the graves. There seems to be souls collecting in
That's
a tomb. There seems to be reoccurring characters that are wearing these dark cloaks that have skull-like masks. Mm. There's definitely some order here, as you do see that this is a story of whatever order resided here.
Write down.
Yes, you can write down a very dark entity encased in a tomb, reaching out with a almost like a Rosetta Stone in his hand. It's very ominous, but the clues would be put together if you have the right information. But that's kind of what you gathered here. There are two statues of Ra down here, as it seems like this is almost like a built on top of another shrine.
Spot hidden.
Yes, you can.
Pass.
At the chamber door that leads to the further of the cursed chamber, you see that there seems to be a keyhole in the shape of a sun. You are missing a piece to progress further.
Can I look for it in the room?
Your spot hidden, it's not in here. You check everything. You check the statues, you check the murals, you check everything.
Where is it? Oh, it's in the chamber of the sun.
In the other chamber.
You guys make it to where the other side, the adjacent side where the hieroglyphs had led you to the chamber of the sun. A natural cave formation inside.
Oh, that's a critical success!
Cool, nice!
You're still woozy from your concussion. One of the walls appears to have a latch hidden inside with all three of you discovering it.
What do you think that does?
Well, if anything, it might launch another trap of sorts, perform itself with the obelisk, or could open up to another room.
Can I, like, see if anything's, like, above?
It does look entrance-like, where it does curve, and it does seem almost like a door would be there.
God, okay.
All right, I'll just pull the latch.
You pull. Okay, I was gonna do it, but in case I died, I was gonna have someone hold my notes.
You can't die.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
because if you die, then we gon' die.
As you hear an ancient mechanism, a heavy mechanism, as you're hearing the rocks shift behind this illusionary wall, they begin to fold upon themselves and roll out as it reveals the sandstone entrance to an actual official tomb here, as it seems to open up, as there's that entryway blocked by now a sandstone wall, as it's, you hear that mechanism start to strain and stress and struggle, as you hear an internal collapse as the mechanism then winds down as you unlock this new entrance, but the door seemed to, that was opening to reveal the tomb, collapses back on itself.
Shit. Marvelous anyways, and I jot down what I just saw.
So how are we gonna get through that?
How big was the gap when it did open?
It was, I'd say, a foot.
Well, and can we see where the mechanism was? Like, is there a rope attached?
Make a listen check.
Ooh, no.
You could follow the mechanism going, you heard it in the wall as it kind of like went, but you lost it. You can't pinpoint it.
Could I try to listen for it?
Yes, you can.
Oh, pass.
Yay.
It seemed to have broken just by where the left of the door is.
Mm. Well, do we have chisels?
Well, has it been that 20 minutes?
It has been that 20 minutes.
Oh, we should probably walk back. Anyway. Yeah, okay.
Hi.
As you guys, you guys rendezvous at
the
obelisk.
So we found an amazing room with an ingenious mechanism that opens up what seems to be another compartment chamber. Really ingenious work by the Egyptians. Can we switch rooms? I want to go into the bad room.
No, we need to find something in your room that will unlock something in our room.
I say we go to this whatever sun thing. We see what's there.
We all go to the sun room.
Hopefully we find that amulet and then we go back together to the other room.
Who else can climb?
I can jump.
You make it back to the cave. Very familiar, you guys. And you,
archaeology.
As you guys are new here.
Pass.
You use your tools described by the location given by Dr. Hargrave as you chip away and you unveil the roots of this mechanism.
Fixer.
I mean, I can try, but...
You were quite ingenious with that lockpick.
Repair check, please.
I will also repair check.
Pass.
But I don't have to.
A temporary repair. One that may only work a few times because the strain of this door is so heavy.
About.
The next time you pull that lever, it will work.
And I don't know how many times I can fix this.
So it might stay open.
Do we want to try that?
Let's do it.
You hit the lever, your repair works. The door is open enough to go through. Who goes through?
I go through.
Okay, as the tomb door
is open.
For now. God.
You are welcomed by a chilling, stuffy air down here, as no one has been down here in a long, long time.
And inhalers haven't been invented.
Oh, no.
So I smoke.
It helps.
Is there shit on the wall I can read?
Spot hidden,
everybody.
That's
every success, I'll give
pass.
New Ooh, piece of information.
Pass. Critical
pass.
Critical
pass.
Okay, it counts as two
pass.
Things. One thing, 14 foot.
Pass.
Everyone passes except for you. There are two levels to this chamber of the sun. On this level that you've entered now, you notice that there's a corridor that goes to a chamber to the right and to the left. As on this base level here, this is where whatever rituals would happen here. There is a great scarab mural on the ground here, as there is a stepstone that reveals a chest, a golden chest. There are also two scarab, almost aquamarine colored statues in the back as well. There are also chambers that lead to the right on the second as well.
Stay together.
I'm definitely splitting up and not being with you.
Fair enough. Alex.
I call left.
Gwen and I were going left.
There is a pit trap.
No.
It seems like it's about 10 foot and there's spikes down there. As on the other side, a pedestal. There seems to be a pedestal and on the ground, a antique mirror with markings of Ra as this mirror has been knocked off of this pedestal across from this gap. Seems jumpable.
Don't tell him that.
Don't let your dreams be dreams. Well,
I passed.
As you go, whee, flying across this 10-foot gap, as you land on the other side with the pedestal and the mirror. You're at this pedestal with the mirror, as surrounding it is the dark abyss around here. But the mirror's on the ground.
I want to look at the mirror.
Very dusty, but you can kind of see yourself in it.
Throw me the brush!
Oh, God. Fine.
Make a throwing check.
Oh, no! Do I have throw?
Alex can throw it, technically. He does have throw.
That looks really close and handy, doesn't it?
Fork! Oh! As you clean the mirror perfectly, revealing almost an ethereal shine to it.
Probably, it's really shiny.
It's probably half your size, to be honest. Like, it's a big mirror, and it can hinge and rotate and turn on many different axes.
What does this mean?
Pass with one.
Crit.
You got a one?
I got a one.
You know a trick. You could guide Tim on exactly where to place that mirror based off of something you've read.
Okay, I do it.
I told
you. Oh, shitballs! Poopy shitballs!
That as you angle it perfectly, this beam of this unnatural artificial sunlight ricochets off the wall and sends this very visible orange glow to beam across the way, shining, it's hitting the back of you three that are at the other door here as you see this. How do you get back?
Anything that I can see that I can make like a bridge with.
Make an intelligence check.
Pass.
There was a ladder right next to the pit.
Come on, darling.
I'm coming! Oh, that was easy. Wow.
As you make it across and you're now back in that main level one floor right there. Side number two.
Yes.
Another broken mirror. A statue, almost like a guardian Anubis here that has like an axe that you can recognize this mechanic as if you step on it and activate the trap, it's gonna go back forth. It seems like this trap will activate no matter what.
Wow, we got the worst side.
There's no symbols on the ground or anything.
Not with this layer of dust caked over it.
If the pressure plate stays activated, will the blade stay down?
You can find out.
I go collect rocks.
So that does take enough time to where you guys return from your thing. Did you notice that everyone's collecting like a shirt full of like rocks?
What is happening?
So there are pressure plates in the other room and we're trying to figure out which one will activate the blades that we've chopped down.
Can I go and archaeologize them?
You reveal this first layer of pressure plates as you do recognize there are different symbols. So some of these pressure plates have the symbol of Ra, the god, on them.
Maybe we have to step on Ra. Because Ra is the god of life and the sun.
Who wants to sacrifice? I mean, go first.
Well, let's put a rock on it to see if it will activate it.
Gotta be heavy enough.
And then we put a very heavy rock.
You guys put a very heavy rock on this pressure plate of Ra, as it does not go down, the trap does not activate. Now, your only problem is that you don't know where the next pressure plate of Ra is.
Well,
the next layer reveals no more symbols. It seems like it would be two away.
It's a waltz. Who can die? Yeah,
okay,
Well, if you activate them all, what if I chop my way through the place?
No, our best bet then is if they're swinging, they're going to be swinging in some pattern, obviously. If someone who is nimble on their feet and can sense and can get the timing right.
Oh, I am dexterous and charming.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. I'm ready.
Go ahead. So, you can do it.
We should activate. Oh, yeah. We need to activate them.
You should do it.
I'm going to activate the blades so we can start getting this pattern going.
Intelligence to recognize the pattern.
I'm going to roll two.
I'm going to roll.
That's a pass.
Okay.
Crit.
Okay, sorry, man.
Crit. I'm so smart.
Bitch, no, you're not.
There is that moment where they all open up that gap. There's a perfect timing.
How long? What's the time?
I'd say it gives you 2 seconds of dash. It'd be a dex check.
I'll do it.
But you don't have to roll dodge. You just gotta roll dex.
I'll do it.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
27.
Really just throw this guy.
Why didn't we choose him?
Because it's smart.
You guys,
let's go!
As it opens up, you get that running start. You dash past all these blades as you make it to the pedestal with the mirror on the ground.
These mirrors love me. I mean, what can I say?
Okay,
and because you were taught by Gwen the last time, you know exactly what to do. You place the mirror as the second one, as that beam then goes into the chest room. That's...
So wait, I'm stuck on the other side right now, right?
Oh yeah, yeah, I wanna get back?
Maybe.
Dex check.
Oh, I'm gonna die this time. I can see
it. Don't say that!
I'm fine. Okay, quick.
Oh, nice.
All right.
Okay. Alex, are you proud of me?
Are you impressed?
I'm impressed.
I'm not just charm.
As you guys enter
the main chamber,
the sun is beaming on the chest right now. You can either go ahead and try it now, or you can investigate that fourth chamber.
We need to find the key.
I'm gonna investigate spot the fourth
hidden.
Chamber.
Yeah. Spot hidden.
Spot hidden in the fourth chamber?
Yes, all of us.
Okay.
Pass.
Critical pass.
Did not pass.
No, okay,
pass.
Here's what you guys find. It ain't pretty. You guys see that at the this is an empty
there's a mummy right there.
This is an empty chamber that has cobwebs and it's dark and illuminated by your torches.
What was that? Look what you just did.
Torch it. At the back of this wall, you see a familiar symbol. You see the same symbol that was on the amulet. To you, an unknown hieroglyphic. To you, you know what it is.
Strange. It has the same symbol as the amulet.
It does.
I'm gonna put my ear on it and knock.
Listen check.
Pass!
Yay. Hollow.
Actually, crit!
Hollow. But more so.
Wow! Super empty.
Super empty.
You can extra hollow.
I'm gonna feel around to see if there's anything that can give. Any part of the wall that I can push on.
As there is a rotating door within the wall, like a turnstile, where as you guys see Dr. Hargraves vanish before your eyes.
Shit.
Is he dead?
Yeah.
No, he went behind that fucking wall.
Dr. Hargraves.
Okay, spot hidden. I'm gonna look for the button again. Button
go
search.
For it.
Pass.
We can all go inside now, yay!
You guys can go inside.
All of us.
Who goes inside this room?
I really want to.
Very well.
I persuade everyone but myself.
So you're gonna be alone in the other one?
Well, let's check this out.
Okay.
Spy hidden, everybody!
Spy hidden!
So we all go in, is that what's happening?
Yes.
I didn't go in.
All right, so we're all in except all Joseph.
So you're out there by yourself.
Joseph, no, come in with us.
I have to stay outside.
You don't have to.
In
secret tunnel. Secret tunnel. Into a chamber.
Did you pass your spot hidden?
No.
I did.
I'm too enamored with everything.
Shit. And you super failed with 100%.
I super passed.
Okay. Super. And you, Eli?
I did not pass.
Thank God for Gwen right now. Did you pass there?
Of course not.
Apparent to everybody, in the center of this room, there is a mechanism. You hear a wood kind of crank as there is a swirling pool of red, thick blood.
Oh.
How do we know it's blood?
I can swim.
Do you want to taste it? You want to drink it?
Don't do that.
It'll make you young again.
Step inside.
What do I do? What do I roll?
Do you want to do it?
Don't do it! Please honestly, don't drink blood. I'm telling you right now, drinking blood
well, let's
gives you diarrhea.
Well, let's reveal everything
do
first.
Not drink
first,
blood.
Gwen, as they're yeah. as they're like taking their pinky into the blood, you notice that there are hieroglyphs on the edge of this pool. Do you want to make a language?
Yes. Okay.
To read.
Yes, reading.
Fuck.
I pass.
The blood of the accursed.
Don't touch it.
So everyone, this is the
You find a goblet, Gwen.
Me?
You find a goblet, and also you find two papyrus scrolls.
Oh.
Wow.
Can we open them?
Oh, you shit. Open them. You can open it.
You can open
Here,
them.
Can
there
I
seems
open
to be a bunch.
No, they're mine.
Jesus.
definitely supposed to drink that blood with that goblin.
I'm gonna drink it.
Eternal youth.
It's blank.
It's like the Kung Fu Panda scroll.
There's nothing on it.
There are also
dragon warrior.
There are also cult symbols on the goblet.
Okay, no.
I persuade you to give it.
As you open the scroll, it is blank.
Can I do a cult check?
The both scrolls are blank.
Pass.
That goblet. This room. You recognize this ritual of dark magic. To gain the power of the accursed, you must drink the well of blood.
I charm him to hand it to me.
Do you want this? Here.
I
want to. First, I just want to see what this does.
No, don't do that. Stop it. No, I persuade you to stop.
No, please, Dr.
Tackle.
I persuade you to stop.
Can I tackle
you? You stop.
Him?
Crit.
They're about to attack you. What do you do?
I drink.
Crit. No, you stop.
No!
Is everyone okay?
As you drink blood, you notice that his eyes, his pupils fade and turn to a blood red as
holy shit.
You are entrapped in your brain currently as there is just cultist voices whispering into you.
Oh my god.
Shoot him.
This is how this is going to work. You are going to make, what's your constitution skill?
50.
You have 3 successes and right. 3 passes. Oh to see gosh, if your I'm blood gonna... takes with your body.
I need a cigarette.
I still have no idea what's going on.
You're on the side of the
preschool! Not pass.
Fail. Uh-oh, he's gonna die.
Hiya! Pass!
Alright.
Go.
Putting all the cigarettes
so
in my mouth.
Alright.
Alright. For Papa! Fail.
He's dead.
He's gonna die?
No.
He's world dead.
Be proud of me, Papa!
Fail.
You notice he...
Shoot him.
...returns to the present as the ritual does not fully take as he throws up. One of his eyes is not returned as you have suffered almost like there's like a haze and a half blindness. You are seeing doubles almost and triples here as I need you to make an occult check.
Oh, pass. Major pass.
Gwen is holding one of those blank scrolls. As you are seeing with one of your eyes, letters begin to form, but they're only half complete, as these entire papyrus scrolls are aligned with what seems to be necrotic spells of necromancy and blood rituals.
Oh, no.
And this, as you can read it, But you can only see half of it because your ritual did not fully take. You rejected it.
So,
you
what do you
make another occult check here as you are able to blindly see.
Pass.
The first scroll is a scroll of command undead, and the second is a ray of enfeeblement, as these are spells. But you can only see half of them, meaning that it's going to be a hard check for you to use them.
We're gonna need these.
What is
and
wrong
I'm gonna
with
need
you?
This.
No!
I go back
no.
for
oh, no!
What?
If you fail, it will purge out of your system entirely.
I will have the knowledge! Oh, crit!
You did it! Done!
Okay!
I was bad. Projectile vomiting.
Can you read it now?
See.
Everything.
Why are you talking like that? That's
so funny. He's not an evil bad guy.
He's now evil.
There is an immense amount of power that's flowing through your veins now as you can read this lost curse.
Oh, it's a centerfold.
I'm keeping
it's
the other
a centerfold.
Gwen, I'm going to keep the other one for insurance.
Yeah. Just in case.
Which scroll does he have then? Which scroll do you want? Did you want? You only get one right now because Philomena's holding on to the other one. Did you want Command Undead or Ray of Enfeeblement?
Control Undead.
Okay. Do you guys leave this room?
Okay, we have to look at the golden chest.
His eyes are blood red.
Like, golden chest.
Blood, you go to the chest?
We have to look at it.
Open the chest.
Yes. No lid, no nothing, but since you guys have connected the sun, there is a hatch that seems to, a compartment that's open now based off of the sun. What did you just say?
Open.
You open it. It reveals the sun key with the exact shape.
Oh my god, thank god.
For the cursed tomb. There's also this.
Fuck! I don't touch it.
What is that?
Does it jump out at me?
Nope.
It's a scarab.
Don't touch it.
I'll grab it.
I touch it.
No, don't touch it.
I want it.
Don't touch it.
You guys.
Sleight of hand.
Begin to hear.
No.
You notice that the two scarab statues, their jaws are opening, the mouths are opening.
Run.
A swarm of scarabs vomit out of each of them as they go.
Okay.
As they're formulating, as they're flying on top of each other and mangling as they're covering this entire floor of this level here.
Run!
Grab the scarab,
grab the key!
Grab the key! Grab both!
As you have the keys, you guys are running. Basically, you have this narrow pathway as you're coming here. I need you to make a dex check, and if you can't make that dex check, we'll work with what we got here.
Pass.
Critical pass.
Thank
nice.
God. Yay!
All go up the stairs. The light is fading as you guys exit out the door out of that cave there. All seven of you, one at a time, just pass.
How do we
close the door,
Break the mechanism, it'll close the door.
You jam it in there, the mechanism just fully collapses upon itself as this door caves in. Blocking as you guys hear the dead.
Let's take a smoke break.
Can I investigate this?
First piece of treasure you guys got.
Puts it in his pocket, and then sleight of hand.
You try and sleight of hand that? Roll it.
If we were in any other rooms,
no, I'm gonna intimidate you to give it to me.
Missing from like the wall or some like part of the floor or a statue, like some piece fit in.
That just seems like a regular trinket at this current time.
Oh yeah.
And I guess it gets swiped. You say interesting back pocket, and then yoink right out of it.
Yoink.
I want to intimidate him to give it to me.
No, you only you think he has it.
Oh okay.
No one knows Tim has it.
You mean the J? The J. Is that
me? The jewel. All right.
After you drank the blood, we really don't trust you. We're so honest.
Excuse me, I am the only one that can read these scrolls now, okay?
Your pocket's empty.
Where's the jewel?
It's...
Weird.
Don't be playing around.
Make a spot hidden check, Joseph.
I'm gonna make a spot hidden check.
I start looking at the ground.
Critical.
Yeah.
You pat him down, and it's missing.
Okay, so.
Okay, guys, first up, who took it?
Someone must have taken it, otherwise it would be on the ground here.
Psychoanalysis
versus charm here. Both of you see what happens
charm.
Here.
I think it's Alex who took
it. I passed. Pass.
I passed as well.
Fuck.
I got a 34.
I got 71.
Okay, then that means that you could tell that he's lying. You're the only one that could tell that he's lying.
Let's just go to the next two.
No, give it to me. Let's go to the next two.
I'm not gonna give it to you.
I've already.
Give me your gun.
Hey, you take mine.
Oh, thank you.
No. What?
Give
hang
it
on,
to
hang
me.
On, hang on. That's my
oh my
boy
god.
Right there.
See, Alex is on my side. Alex is on my side.
Why are you to me?
I persuade her to give me the gun. I persuade her to give me the gun. Why is she in charge now?
Give it to me.
No.
Okay, what is happening? He has been reckless. He's jeopardizing all of our lives.
Yeah, but he's the only reason we're here.
Yes, but he is the one that's going to kill us.
Well, then maybe he should just wait outside.
Can I slide a hand when this argument happens?
Will allow you to roll
we're just
a
screaming at each
sleight
other.
Of hand check while this argument is going on.
Let's just go to the other tomb and continue this mission.
It's fine.
You get it.
I'm trying my best.
I apologize. My temper got the best of me. I'm very sorry, I didn't mean to.
Oh, Christ.
You go to the other tomb.
I would like to do a language check.
This is the story that these hieroglyphs tell.
Oh, God, okay.
This is what this mural, this tomb is.
Spectacles, I guess.
There was an ancient order of necromancers, the death priests that were obsessed with immortality and eternal life. Mm. The rituals, sadistic, evil, but proved results. As the high priest, a hieroglyph, it reveals that he holds a black obsidian, almost Rosetta-like stone type tablet marked as the Tomb of Immortality, as the inscriptions on this tomb seem to be written in a fiery red glow. But on this mural, once that he discovered the power of immortality, nobles and royalty of Egypt would flock to him and offer kingly troves of wealth and jewels and everything imaginable and give in hopes of immortality. But all of them deceived, as in order to prolong your soul, you must take what's left on other people's souls.
Oh, Jesus.
What?
But that did not stop the Order of Ra. There was a mural of a great battle, as it seems like they were completely outmatched now, and they were losing much men. There seems to be, there was a weaponry where they were using one of those mirrors from earlier in the Sun Tomb as a beam of light to try and disorient it. It seems like they had entrapped the high priest alive within a tomb, locked him away to have a never-ending punishment for his crimes and suffering. The death priests were mummified alive, and it all leads to this door that is hidden behind the key. There's wordings. Do not progress. Do not open. Warning, 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 warning. All those who take from this tomb will be cursed.
Can we just open the door?
Do you see anything special with your special eyes?
Do I see anything special with my special eyes?
This tomb was created by the Order of Ra. There's nothing in here for you.
Here's my current train of thought. Is behind that door, if the high priest has been mummified alive, he will most likely be behind that door, or because he's his torment.
Right, but we need to find the amulets.
We do, but there is that possibility, that chance. We could be stumbling into a very biologically weird situation.
So you mean...
You said kingly troves of rewards here.
I think we should just go, because, you know...
What do you think, Alex? What do you think we should do?
I'm thinking that we might have the biggest payday of our lives. King Tut might be a joke compared to this, if what they're saying is real.
I'm convinced.
All that gold, that's what I'm here for.
I'm ready. I don't know about you guys. It's not about the gold offered, it's about the principle.
I say we open it.
It's about finding out
the truth. I mean, we've gone through everything so far. It wasn't that bad, right? We only almost died a few times. So,
yeah, we're pretty agile getting around those scarabs.
Can we open the door?
Raise your hand if your team opened.
Opened it. Opened.
Opened it.
Nice.
You guys enter this crypt. What lays before you from your lantern, from your torch, illuminated, is three sarcophagi. If that's the plural word for it, don't.
I think so.
Don't Google me.
I think so.
Sarcophagi, I believe, is the plural. Yes.
As you enter, glyphs of your accursed blood begin to shine. Do you read them? A prayer that if you want to get into these sarcophagus, you must summon the high priest.
Three amulets, three chests. Okay, we gotta open the chests.
Can we?
Is one chest more ornate than the others?
They're the same.
Yeah, because these are all
his
servants.
I say we open
them. Looks bigger.
We made it this far. I think
you're just tired.
They're unopened.
It's delirium.
We can't open them.
It's saying we need to summon him with a prayer.
Do it.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
God is great. God is good. Let us thank him for it.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. I can do it in French.
I think that should do it.
This treasure better not end up being friendship you make along the way. I swear to God.
I can also do it in Spanish.
You made it along the way, that's your absolute right.
Well, we could summon this priest. However, it seems he was quite powerful, and we have no guarantee.
Persuade him to do it.
He's a corpse. He's not going to come.
Persuade him to do it.
Well, in that case, why should we summon? Why should we try to summon it?
Because we need to open these things, because this is where the amulets are.
Maybe the vibrations of sound.
We've made it this far. I think, as Alex said, this is where the potential riches are. I think we need to do whatever it says we're supposed to do.
Okay.
Just do it.
Okay.
Just do it.
Occult check. He is saying words in a dialect and accent that you just see something take over his body right now. There is a pause moment after he is finished.
I've heard of this.
The ground rumbles for a split second as you can feel that something has been awoken. As you hear a menacing roar, a demonic roar, out of this plane of existence, roar and echo through this chamber. As and the lids fly off into the ceiling, crushing the stone, leading up these mummified death priests, the walking, fleshing corpse. Step out of the sarcophagus and attack. You get to go first. Spit out your actions. What do you do?
Shoot.
Fire.
You guys fire? Okay. Yeah. Handgun.
I don't have weapons.
I'm gonna stay outside.
You are frightened from this encounter that you miss the bolt. You notice that your gun packs a punch, but the pistol ammunition just goes through. It seems to wound it and it steps out, but it does not immediately kill it. What do you do?
Charm them.
What do you say to it?
Are they wearing any amulets or anything? Oh no.
Each of them around their necks has an amulet of the dead priest.
We'll bring you to your priest if you hand over the amulets.
Oh, make a dodge.
No.
Bam!
Oh, Matt, shit!
As you
go
flying
against
the side of the wall as you deal 1 HP damage.
If there is a prayer that activates them, then they're afraid of Ra, right? So there must be something that can maybe like spook them away. Like the priests of Ra are coming. Are there any prayers in ancient Egyptian I might know that worship Ra?
That's fucking Ra.
History check.
Okay.
Ooh.
That is a pass.
With a prayer of Ra.
Okay.
You can stun it for one round.
I'm gonna look at Alex, because I don't want to put you in jeopardy.
Yeah!
Alex, watch my back! And I go to...
Okay!
And I go to... kind of like, I'm not super close, but I'm kind of against the wall. That's me. And I do a prayer of Ra towards the mummy that is attacking Clyde.
You're saying this other ritual, a counter ritual, should we say.
Will obey.
Occult check.
Malakaliki.
Oh, pass.
What do you command it to do?
Kneel.
What the fuck?
Oh, God.
It kneels.
Amulet.
Just one. As it reaches out the amulet.
One is done. So
one is being commanded.
Okay, so I'm gonna shoot the one that's like not being.
Shoot it.
Yeah. I'm gonna shoot it in the leg. 70. Yeah, good.
The shotgun blast, well, how close do you get to it?
Pretty damn close.
The shotgun blast obliterates it into a puff of dust and linen wrap as your shot scatters it across the ground here as this lowly priest returns to the afterlife. You have a free action here as is currently stunned. What do you do?
Rip off the amulet.
Yoink! You're currently locked in concentration on commanding this one. Now you can try and make another command.
Release your blood. This
one.
Yeah! Call check.
Oh, nice crit.
Mummified priest walks up to the other and takes its hand and pops its head in a cloud of dust as the linen wrap just falls, as there is only one mummified priest left.
Cold.
Right there for our... Oh, I guess Alex hasn't gone yet. Do you want to save your bullet?
Yeah, I'm going to save my bullet.
BAM! As he releases both barrels of the shotgun into it as it plumes into dust and destroys it.
Good kill, Alex.
Can I ask a dumb question? Would I know how many bullets are in his gun? Like what kind of, what load it carries?
His?
Yeah.
Two, that's it. Yeah.
Okay, two.
He's
okay.
Done now.
Okay, I'm keeping track of everyone's bullets.
So you believe in the magic now or no?
As you guys emerge out of the tomb, you realize that night has faded.
Wonderful.
It's morning.
Oh my god.
Fuck.
Oh god. Your eyes must be like.
Put the amulets in.
Do we know where that?
Do we know what kind of treasure we're gonna get out of this thing?
If the treasure most likely will be whatever the priest got from the nobles and the pharaohs who were looking for their services. So if, I shouldn't even say, this is going to be a sizable payout.
As you guys circle the obelisk and open the compartment, you hear
Alfie.
The sound of glasses clicking on the ground as someone has thrown it from above. As you look up,
no!
You see Renald Belair as there are several henchmen that surround this cliffside, all with guns pointed at you. Shit. As you see Alfie beaten and bruised and I'm sorry, boss.
What about the groceries?
I didn't get the groceries. I got beat up. As basically all these guys around the perimeter here is.
Alfie, no.
Everyone stay still.
Renald has the gun to Alfie.
All right.
You want to tell me who you are?
Alex has his gun pointed up at him too. Before dropping to you.
Fucking you, like motherfucker!
I thought we had something!
Okay. I do stop for a moment and I go, I fucking told you. I charm Alex. Oh my god.
Can I charm him?
Oh fuck, we're back to this.
Whoa.
Oh my god.
We've been through so much. What do you want?
Who are you talking to at this point?
I'm talking to Renald.
I want the treasure.
What treasure? We haven't found anything.
Shh, calm down. I handed this.
Alex goes, yeah, there's supposed to be a fuck ton of treasure here.
Oh, God, Alex.
Alex.
I dropped the amulet.
Do it. Let him have it.
Enter here.
We each have one.
By the way, who took the amulets?
I have one.
He has one. I'll take one.
Who took the third?
Because we're on it, I'll take it.
Yeah. I think I do.
I took one from the mummy. Yeah.
Those who take from the cursed tomb, you will add this red d20 to every one of your rolls and increase that as a percentage.
Oh, fuck.
You are cursed.
Renald, I'll give you the same deal I gave them. I'll help, I'll translate, I'll do whatever you need.
You're jumping ship.
You're hired. Put the amulet.
I put it in.
Okay.
I should have just gotten fucking mech. That would have been
putting it in right now.
All the three other mechanisms. As the ground around the obelisk seems to shake, as platforms begin to lower, as a staircase that goes down and down and down descends to the tomb of the high priest.